Hello and welcome to the Munchin Club. I'm Bood and this is season 2 episode 3, technically episode 5, and it's the end of season. We're going to find out how well we've done. Did we manage to win the league? Did we manage to get promotion? Are we in the playoffs? Or did we throw it all away? It's been exciting. I can't tell you how much I love playing in Germany. So much so, I was contemplating doing Denton Villa personal save at some point. I think I'm going to stay in Germany on my own and do it. It's a toss-up at the minute. It's either Dynamo Dresden or Rostock. But it's definitely, I want to do a definite East German team and try and win the Bundesliga. But for now, we're still here with the Munchin Club. I'm loving it. Hopefully you're still enjoying it. Enough to smash the like button. Make sure you subscribe if you're new. Catch up with the series. Stick around for all my new content. And yeah, got a bit to get through. And we've had to finish with a cheeky live comp. We've got to do it, and you'll see why in a few minutes. Now we're going to start here, and I signed one more player before the window closed, right near the death of the transfer window, because I've got through most of the season with two strikers, Ider, who's been great, and Woodburn. Woodburn's played quite a lot out wide on the left, and that's it. Now I did intend to give one of my academy players a chance as a third choice striker without realising he was too young to play my first team for most of the season, so I felt like I needed something just in case. We got into the end of this season, we're battling out for promotion, and one of them boys, or both of them boys, got injured, we'd be doomed. We really would be in trouble. First big game, really, was away against Kaiserslautern, who were battling out up there with us at the top of the league, and away from home. Now, this was some game. They scored early, we equalised. Then they scored. Then we took the lead, and then they came back into it. It was a great game. I was just a bit frustrated. The very next game was against Union Berlin, another team we're battling out with in the top like 4 to 5 in the league. And this was a bore fest. We missed a penalty, Ida. Possibly his worst ever game. Statistically, it was even. We're probably lucky actually to come away with anything. The last game I'm going to share with you, and we played a lot, this is the last game I'll share with you. It was away to St. Pauli, who that's one of the teams I like. I like a bit of St. Pauli. Another team I always meant to have a save with and never got round to doing it. I need to spend more time in Germany, I think. But we battered him and we should have scored more. The good thing about it was my goal scorer and man of the match is an academy player. He's that young midfielder that I've been retraining. So at this point, we've got two games left. And I saved it at this point to come back to show you because we achieved promotion. So at this point in time, we were guaranteed promotion, and we've got to play those dudes who are battling out at the bottom of the table in the next game, and then the very last game of the season, the live con we're going to have today is again away against the league favourites Hanover, who are well out of it, aren't they? I mean, could they do something here? I don't know if they could. It's a goal difference thing. They need these teams to maybe lose. They'll win, they get 59, and they need to sort the goal difference out to sneak in to the playoff position. But as far as the top two, that's set in stone. Kaiserslautern kind of drifted off a bit. Now, we've gone on this great run, but Union Berlin have just stuck with us. The best bit as well is Ida has scored his 20 goals. So don't have to eat a hat. I've reversed the date, so we're going upwards. And obviously that was the last live con, last episode, 1-1 with Dynamo Dresden. And after that, we just kept dropping points. We drew the next game, then we won against Heidenheim, 3-2. And then we went draw, then the two games I showed you. And then from that point on, it was amazing. I don't know if it's the 6-0 against the crap team. I had a bagging 4 goals. He knew I was this close to eating a hat. He helped me out there. I've just had some great victories. Some of them have been close. Some of the games have been close. But they've been exciting games. I mean, that winner came. Both goals came from centre half there. The winner in the 85th minute. And the last game against Darmstadt. They aren't the best team either. It's alright. That fantastic run. What? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 games on the bounce we've won. But in Union Berlin have just stuck with us. So if you look at their form, I mean, they lost a couple. They got knocked out of the quarterfinals and they lost a league game. And then they've only drawn 2, so they've kind of crept up on us. And then just been winning and winning and winning and winning. Now, they've just beat Hanover. And they've got Bochum. And then they're going to be playing Dynamo Dresden. So, It should be fun. Financially, we are struggling, but we're guaranteed promotion. We're guaranteed top two. We should pay that debt off and hopefully get some decent sponsorship and investment because we're going to the Bundesliga. And I mean, finishing top two, that's guaranteed, isn't it? We're guaranteed at least 14 million. So that should cover the debt and put 7 million in the bank. But I'm not being silly. I know I'm not going to get into that Bundesliga and get a load of money. I know I'm not. There's no way that's going to happen. We're not going to get bought by anyone. It's always fan-owned. I've made sure this club will always be fan-owned. So we're always going to be on the breadline. So really, really going to have to get free players and loan players again. When it comes to scoring goals, we've been great. We've had a few games where we score one, maybe two, but then we have some cracking games where we score six. And we create a lot of chances. That's the annoying thing. Even in games we get beat or draw, we seem to create chances. It's just getting that ball in the net. Our defence has been pretty good. Hanover's got the best defence. I mean, they were favourites. I'm really surprised how they've not been that clever. And Kaiserslautern as well, they came up with us. So I think we've both shocked a lot of teams this season. But they're just going to have to boil a bit. Well, that can happen. I mean, I thought we might, because we at one point we had a lot of injuries. I've just been having to pick the best team I possibly could every game. I've not had a chance to rotate or anything. I've had to go for it. But we've just clicked into gear. And they say that about the NFL. I love the NFL. And you can be crap all year, but if you can turn it on in December, there's always a chance. Even if you're a team that's won six and lost six, there's always a chance you can turn it around in that one last month and kick on a bit of form and get to the playoffs. And we've kicked on that bit of form, got promotion, but now I want the title. This is the squad, range by average rating. You can see I've got a lot more players over a seven now with a nice chunky green, which is great. A lot of them are my low knees, but these are good top quality players. From England, and I'm probably going to do the same. I'm going to try and get some of them back. Andre Green, if I can get him back for the Bundesliga, I will. A couple of them will. That Massengo, who annoys me, by the way, the lad's mixed race, right? He's got a big afro, but when you go on the 3D engine for him, he's got light brown hair and he's white. I don't know why that annoys me. They should put a bit more thought into the players, real players, shouldn't they? They should represent what they are on the pitch, I think. But anyway. If you see who's third, you'll see it's Tobias, who's obviously been playing a lot more. As soon as he became more natural in the position, he's getting into the team and playing well. I mean, look, third best player in my team. That's an academy player. My fullbacks are doing all right. He just think he wants a new deal. Don't worry about that. So the couple of kids I've given a chance to have not let me down. And I feel really proud. Right, we've played our game, and I think they're called Gru. I'd call them Gruther. Not Scooby-Doo, but it is what it is. Looks similar to Celtic when you play him. But we did enough. 1-0. Ida actually scored a penalty. I don't know if you noticed, but he misses quite a few. So he actually scored the penalty, and we absolutely battered him. We should have put this game to bed. We didn't, but we did just enough. How about Union, though? Have we won the league? We almost won it. Until Mr. Patrick Eras scored a fucking winner in the 91st minute. Do you know what? It's always great, isn't it? I like a bit of drama. I like it when it goes, no, do I like it? No, I don't. I don't know if I do. I don't know if my heart likes going down to the last game of the season. I mean, it's like, I kind of wouldn't mind going to the playoffs for entertainment purposes for you. But would I enjoy that personally? No. I just want to win the league. And I want to win the league today. Until the 91st minute, they were drawing. So they would have ended up with 67 points. Ended up getting an extra two, didn't they? So we would have won the league. We could have gone into this last game of the season without a care in the world, and it would have been great to go into his last game of the season and play Wiesbaden, who are at the bottom of the league and absolutely crap. But we're not, we're playing Hanover, who are fifth, they're not going to get promoted, but they were favourites for a reason. So they're not shit, are they? Now, when we played them earlier in the season, we beat them 2-1, which is amazing. They were a great team, and I was buzzing at the time. Cardoso and Ida got a penalty, bloody hell! Penalties coming out of nowhere. We're not at home, we're away. We also have some good players injured. I mean, Weber is a bit part player. Dreyer does played quite a lot, he's gone. Victor, the new guy, he can't play. Andre Green, he can't play, he's my best player. Jack Clark, who kind of struggled at first, I don't know if it's because he came to Germany, he kind of struggled early on in the season. He's been a bit of an impact player without making an impact. Until he got the knock, though, he started to pick up his form. One game, he set a goal up. He scored the winner. It was amazing. And that was recently, but then he's got a knock as well. So I think we've got enough depth, though. We've still got enough quality. I'm just a bit nervous. And if we look at Union Berlin's squad, I mean, they're looking great. They look like they're going to do pretty well today. I mean, they play in Dresden. Good team. I like Dresden. We drew against them. And they're going away. So Dresden's, you know, we know all about that. Great stadium, great fans. Hopefully they can do to Union what they did to us and at least take some points away from them, even if it is a draw. But I mean, with this guy up front, they're looking pretty good, aren't they, Mr. Anthony Hoosier? But of course, you know, we've got to do our job. It's all great thinking, come on, Dresden, do us a favour. Hopefully Union have an off day. But we've got to do our job. Now, our job is almost kind of done. There is a chance we can draw this, isn't there, and get 72 points. And they'd get 70, 71, 72 points if they win, right? And we could win it on goal difference. But at the minute, we're only ahead on three. So it's all maths. And I'm shit at maths. The best thing we could possibly do is win this. And the bookies think we can do it. I believe we can do it. This is the third live come in the series. I've still not won one. Hopefully it's a loss, a draw, and this time a fucking win. Here we are at Hanover, and yeah, I've had to make some changes. Obviously, we've got the youngster on the right wing. We've got Woodburn on the left. We've just, you know, injuries and so on. The midfield's looking new. The kid's getting another game, but he's been great. Sengo's kind of took over from Tete. Done a better job, really. Tete's older. Maybe his head went off the boil once he decided to leave. This is Depoff, right? He's my youngster, my young right back, who's got one of these standard regen faces. Standard regen face. They're a bit different on FM19, but they all look similar to this, right? But then my left back has got this really arty, fancy face. Why has he got this face? And I don't remember him having that face originally. It's like it's changed and I don't know why. But an update happened, and if they better, they'd get a better regen face. What am I missing? Because he's got shadowy effects and everything there, hasn't he? Here we go, and we're playing in green again. Away from home again. Hopefully we could do the job here. I'd love one of my youngsters to shine in today's game. I love Ida at bag four. I just want to win it. Let's pick up an actual trophy. A nice big silver disc in the cabinet would be amazing. Going into the Bundesliga as freaking champions and let the rebuild begin. I mean, we're up already. I'll take second. I'm just happy to get there straight away. It's quite cool. Because the series is all about trying to at least beat Bayern once. So as soon as we're in the Bundesliga, better is. But don't forget, the Christmas food is out and he's delivering presents and he's giving away two copies of FM20. The video should have been out before this video. So if you still want to win a copy, if you're one of the hundreds that entered the last competition and didn't win, enter this one. Watch the video. It'll tell you how to enter. Wish I could give a game or something to all of you. I can't. But good luck to those who do enter. Okay, minutes left in the first half and nothing's happened. It's been shit. Hopefully we're not playing for the draw. Well, there we go. First half was a very entertaining live com. This is what I mean. Live coms are great. That's why I love to do them. What a load of shit. Union Berlin are winning 3-0. So if we hop on over to the update page, we'll see at this moment in time, because they're winning 3-0, they've caught me up with a goal difference. It's because they got more goals for. Because overall, we're both on 30. But they're now top of the league. Come on, Munchen. All right, they've kicked off the second half. I'll give them an ass kicking. I've got a full set of greens. I wish we had a green. Mr. Andre Green on the right wing. We're missing a couple of players, I think. But we're still a good team. Still got good players. I'm going to wait to about the 60-minute mark. Oh, come on. Free kick, finally, something. Come on, boys. Come on, boys. You'd be able to tell by the crowd, wouldn't you? They'll have the little radios on. You'd be able to tell that we're not winning the title. We're going up. That's safe. But we're winning no titles. So, yeah, 60-minute mark. I might make some changes. What is it with live comms, man? Hey, this always happens to me. Blood, this is why I hate him. This is why I hate him. Right, come on. We're going to defend this corner. And we're going to hit him on the break. Maybe not. Come on, Munchen. This is when I miss Villa because we had songs for Villa. We used to be able to sing Yellow Is My Colour. Sometimes I want to sing something, but I ain't got a song for Munchen. But I ain't got anything. Nothing's happening. Okay, I made two changes. One in the middle of the park because Masengo was shit. And I brought Clark in on the wing. He's not 100% fit, but he's ready to play. He's only got to do 15 minutes. He was on form. Proper form. Right, I've also demanded more. Everyone's focused, but it's not been great, has it? I mean, we've had a lot of opportunities, but nothing really good enough to be a highlight. But we have scored a lot of last-minute winners, a lot of last-minute equalisers this season. So we've still got it in our locker, unless we go 1-0 down and we say, see that big silver plate? Here you go, Burnley. You have it. Have your dinner on it tonight. I mean, come on. Come on, boys. We're going to get straight back into it. Turn it. Shoot it. Oh! Don't be offside. Don't be offside. Is it a goal? Is it a goal? Let's watch the replay. Guy was getting treatment on the side. So we're down to 10 men. Here's Cardoso. Great shot. Bit of a ricochet. You never know stuff like that, if he's going to be offside or not, but it's not. And we're back to 1-1. Still could be enough. I've not been looking out for Berlin. You might have. But I don't think this is going to happen for us. Union Berlin, 3-1. Could goal difference help us? I have no idea. Munchen move up to first. We've done it. How the hell? How the hell have we just done that? I fucking love this game. I love this game. I love it. Absolutely love it. Confetti graphic is still an absolute load of shit. Equaliser in the 91st minute. What the hell happened with Berlin? I don't know what to say. Words. I need words. So we scored that equaliser, and I'm thinking a draw could be enough, and I got a bit excited. I was looking up in that corner, I don't know if you were, and it just came up, Munchen. No, it came up first, Dresden, it was 3-1, and I noticed that, and then it says Munchen move up to first. So when we scored in the 91st minute, Dresden must have scored like seconds later. Jesus. We won the league by a goal. Adam Ida scored 21, definitely made sure I don't have to eat my own hat. Come on! Brilliant. There you go. We've got a lovely trophy. It is a good trophy. It's still a great trophy. I can't believe it. Can't believe it. Two back-to-back league titles. Are we going to go up and win the Bundesliga? No. But we've got a nice chunk of cash. I mean, look at that. 15 million. We are filthy, bloody rich. Now, I did show you the finances, didn't I? And it was about 7 million. While I was playing the game before this, the board pumped 4 million in. So we kind of half that debt. So the finances should be looking a bit better. We've got 10 million. I'm happy with that. I'm happy not even spending a penny on this freaking save. You know, let's just get into the Bundesliga, get some loans, get some freebies, have some fun. I'm in such a good mood. Now, I don't get this, but apparently now it shows you. I don't know. Did it ever do this in FM19? I don't remember it doing. Who gets medals? To qualify for a medal, a player must play in at least one match. So there you go. We've all got freaking medals, boys. Mr. Gruber, Mr. Hans Gruber himself, the diehard fan of the club, the saviour. He's like a god to me and all the fans of this club. I know he changed the name. Some people still kind of hate him for that. But at least we're here. And we're here with two titles in the cabinet. And what's cool is, well, I think it's brilliant, is Kaiserslautern didn't throw it all away, and they've managed to scrape into third. So they'll be in the playoffs against Freiburg, who finished 16th. FC Bayern. Fuck yeah, won the league again. 10 points, man. We've also got overall best 11, which is not going to be full with superstars because, again, we're only 2 years old. And some new guys have obviously come into it. And I do like how players we've loaned come into it. I think that might have happened in the past, but they deserve to, really. And even the kid, the fact that kid who came in, Heigl, I think he's called, from the academy, and couldn't really get in the team first half of the season and just developed. So he's got better, got into the team and didn't come back out of it really. And he's made the team, which is fantastic. So end of season awards, and Andre Green, best player. He was fantastic. If I can get him back, I'll be well happy. Eric Palmer-Brown as well, great centre-half. Adam Ida, he came in third. Goal of the season as well is Tobias Heigl. Freaking kid. Here we're going. It was a free kick and it was decent. I don't know how he got goal of the season. It was decent. I think we scored better goals. Sign of the season was Benjamin Uphoff, the goalkeeper we got on a free. And obviously we didn't make many actual signings, just him and a right back, I think, wasn't it? Oh, and Tetti as well in the middle. The rest of them pretty much loans. And young player of the season, Andre Green. Fantastic winger. Now, we've just agreed some new club visions. We won't be able to see all of them because of my head. But basically next season, they just want to fight bravely against relegation. The year after, they want to continue in the Bundesliga, and that's it. They just want to stay in the Bundesliga. There's no, I mean, even all the way to 2026, they're not asking me to win it, to become a top team. Just stay in it. Now, Ralph, one of the directors and the guy who designed the club's new logo and all that, He's come to us and told us he's spending $5 million expanding the stadium. I'm guessing this is for the Bundesliga. Money's not going out of our account. I don't know where this magic money comes from, but any investment in the facilities now has got to be a good thing, because we've not done anything. 2 years now, we've not improved a single thing facility-wise. When it came to the team of the year, centre-half got in, goalkeeper got in, and Green got in centrally somehow. I am surprised more players didn't get in. You should all be munching. We're the champions. Who's better than us? And if you're interested, Kaiserslautern lost their playoffs, so Freiburg will be staying in the Bundesliga. And Bayern bored everyone to tears. They've done a back-to-back domestic double for both the first years. This has to change. Now, I won Manager of the Year last year. They had that award in the third division, but not in the Bundesliga too. Just Player of the Week, Team of the Week, Team of the Year, Top Goal Scorer. That's it. Why? Quick look at my profile. And I've got a 63 win percentage. And I think if there was a manager award, I reckon I had a good chance of winning it. I'm a bit disappointed I've not. Now, I play every game. I do holiday in between. If I know something good's happening, I don't. But if I know nothing's happening, I holiday gets through it quicker. Now, this is the shortlist we've got on my patrons on. Of all the patrons pretty much that started when the series started. Now, if you've become a patron since, obviously you won't be able to join this series. But every time I update the Bootyverse, every time I do a new story or anything else, it's just going to get laid on top of the same database. So you are in that. So if you went to, say, my newest video and downloaded the 3.0 version of the Bootyverse, you will be in it. You'll be either at Central or Denton Villa. So I do add you to later versions. Well, Denton just won the league, which is amazing. We won 11 points. And Central came in second after playing a playoff. So they're both now going to be football league clubs. Well, there we go. We're going to finish today's episode there. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. Thank you for smashing the like button. Thank you for subscribing. One last thing. If you're wondering about the youth intake this season, it was shit. Signed a couple of them. It was bad, really, compared to the one before. So I'm hoping for bigger and better things next year, but there's nothing to really show you. So we're not going to worry about them. We're going to concentrate on the few good players we've already got, try and develop them, try and add to them in the summer. And it's going to be a very busy summer for me. The next episode will be the start of season three, the beginning of our Bundesliga adventure and a real freaking challenge to not only build a squad, but to stay in this league. So hopefully you're going to come back for that. Hopefully you're going to stick with the series while it's still on. I'd say there's probably, maybe a season or two left in this. So, you know, it's not going to last forever. But I am enjoying it a lot. And hopefully I'm making you decide to maybe try some lower level German football. But thank you for taking the time to watch. I hope you enjoyed that as much as me. That last minute shit is the best thing about this game. And I am still buzzing with that win. It's amazing. Best way to win a league, that, isn't it? So thank you. Stay safe. Stay happy. Remember, if you want to be in the chance to win a copy of FM20, just go and watch the Christmas video and you'll find out how to enter. But stay safe. I'm Bood. I'll see you next time.